Good morning and welcome to Hope for the Family with Evangelist Noy Antonia Eden. God is good all the time. We bless God for keeping us alive to see this beautiful day which He has made. We rejoice and be glad in it. Shouts of victory and rejoicing ahead in the tent of the righteous. We bless God for making us righteous, for committing unto us the ministry of reconciliation. We bless Him for His faithfulness towards us, that we are appealing with the Spirit of God to the entire world to be reconciled to God. God has opened unto us the door through which the righteous must come in. We pray that we be attentive to the voice of wisdom that will draw near to God, so that God can then draw near to us. In Jesus' mighty name, glory, hallelujah, amen. Today we are praising God because He is our God. He has done great things for us and our families. He has provided all our needs today. Amen. He has anointed our heads with the oil of gladness. We can serve man because God has given us the enablement to do good works for Him in this world. The Spirit of goodness and mercy follows wherever we go. The rod and staff of God protect us from the evil forces of darkness in this world. We have come to know God today, not through our own self-righteousness or through our own human will, but the Spirit of God works in us and through us to perfect everything concerning the kingdom of God, concerning God's will for us on earth here in the name of Jesus. We have come to God today through the covering of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. For the life name is the life of Jesus Christ. We plead the blood of Jesus Christ because we know we have sinned against God. We have sinned against our brothers and sisters in so many ways. We have done things contrary to the will of God. So as we have come before God today, we are asking for forgiveness in ways we have fallen short of the glory of God. Our God is faithful to forgive us of our sins. He does not condemn us when we come to Him with repentant hearts. Glory, hallelujah, amen. We bless God and the Spirit of God is leading us into the most holy place today, where we can enjoy fellowship with God the Father, with the Son, and with the Spirit. As we have come this morning, we just want to sing a chorus before we read Psalm 150 and go into our message for today. Glory, hallelujah, amen. We humble ourselves before God today. Glory, hallelujah, amen. Praise ye the Lord, praise Him. In His sanctuaries, praise Him. In the firmaments of His powers, praise ye the Lord, praise Him. In the sanctuaries, praise Him. In the firmament of His powers, praise ye the Lord, praise Him. In the sanctuary, praise Him. In the firmament of His powers, praise ye the Lord, praise Him. In the sanctuaries, praise Him. In the firmaments of His powers. God is good. He has done us well. For our souls, we rise up and praise the Lord. God is good. For He has done us well. Oh, our souls, we rise up and praise the Lord. God is good. He has done us well. Oh, our souls, rise up and praise the Lord. God is good. God is good. God is good. God is good. Oh, our souls, rise up and praise the Lord. For this God is our God, is our God forever and ever. He will be our guide, for none, even unto the end. For this God, for this God, for this God is our God, you are our God forever and ever. You will be our Haggai, for now, even unto the end, lift up Jesus, he is King of Kings. Lift up Jesus, he is Lord of Lords. Lift up Jesus, he is King of Kings, King of Kings, and Lord of Lords. Hallelujah. Lift up Jesus, he is King of Kings. Lift up Jesus, he is Lord of Lords. Lift up Jesus, he is King of Kings, King of Kings, and Lord of Lords. Amen. We plead the blood of Jesus. We plead the blood of Jesus. We plead the blood of Jesus, the cleansing blood, the blood of Jesus, the healing blood, the blood of Jesus. We plead the blood of Jesus, the saving blood, the blood of Jesus, the powerful blood, the blood of Jesus. We plead the blood of Jesus, the living blood, the blood of Jesus, the healing blood, the blood of Jesus, the powerful blood, the blood of Jesus, the saving blood, the blood of Jesus, the living blood, the blood of Jesus. We plead the blood of Jesus, the miraculous blood, the blood of Jesus. We plead the blood of Jesus, the saving blood, the blood of Jesus, the speaking blood, the blood of Jesus. We plead the blood of Jesus. Glory, hallelujah, amen. For we plead the blood of Jesus on ourselves today, on our families, on our nations, on the body of Christ. We plead the blood of Jesus on our government today. That blood of Jesus that has given us life. We bless God for the blood of Jesus that has cleansed us from all unrighteousness. The blood of Jesus that is speaking on our behalf today, speaking better things than the blood of Abel. We plead the blood of Jesus Christ today. The saving blood of Jesus, the living blood of Jesus, the powerful blood of Jesus, the healing blood of Jesus, the blood of Jesus that can revive our souls and make us the people that God wants us to be. We plead that blood of Jesus Christ today. Glory, hallelujah, amen. That blood that has cleansed us from all iniquity. We thank you for that, Lord, for the sacrifice of our Lord Jesus Christ on our behalf. That sacrifice you have accepted, Jehovah God. No, that sacrifice, Lord of God, can speak on our behalf. We bless you, God, that the life we live today is the life of Jesus Christ. We thank you for everything you have done for us and our families, Lord God, that you have given us that name that is above every other name, the name of Jesus Christ. the name to whom every knee must bow and every tongue confess that Jesus Christ is Lord, to your glory. Father, we bless you today in the name of Jesus. We lift up our banners wherever we are today, in our families, in our communities, Jehovah God, within the body of Christ and our government, Jehovah God, in all the organs of government today. We say, Father, Lord, be thou exalted. We bless you as we lift up our banners this day to say, Father, you are Lord. We bless you, Father, Lord, because you have opened unto us the door through which the righteous must come in. We bless you that your word is alive in us, Father, Lord. It's active and helping us, Lord God, to live the life you have called us to live in this world. We are pulling that strongholds, Father Lord, as we continue to enlighten our eyes to spiritual things. Father Lord, we bless you. You are God. We lift you on high. Who can lift up a standard against us when you are for us? Jehovah God, be that exalted in our families, in our situations, Lord God, in our relationship with our husbands, Lord God, with the husband's relationship with their wives, Lord God, in our relationship with our children, Jehovah God, with our brothers and sisters, with people in our communities, Jehovah God, be that exalted in the name of Jesus. Father, pull down every stronghold. Everyone that have lifted up their voices against us, oh Lord God. Everyone that have taken items belonging to us and our families and are using them for evil purposes, let their evil return upon their heads. Let them be frustrated. Father, arise unto us because you are our God. Deliver us from deep waters in the name of Jesus. Father, overturn the captivity and let the enemy be brought down low in Jesus' mighty name. Let us trample upon the forces of darkness within our families, outside our families. Jehovah God, be thou exalted in our matters. We bless you, God, in the name of Jesus. You are God. You have given us peace that surpasses human understanding. We are entering into your peace today in the name of Jesus. We bless you, God, for the ministry, Lord God, you have entrusted to each family here on earth, Jehovah God. You have called us to the ministry of reconciliation. We are appealing to the entire world, Jehovah God, to turn back from that crooked path, O Lord God. We are employing with the world with your spirit, O Lord God, that men may be reconciled back to you in the name of Jesus. We bless you, God, because our ministries, O Lord God, will prosper. We will be fruitful here on earth in the name of Jesus. We come against every stumbling block, everything that will lift up a standard against, O Lord, your will in our lives, in our families, in our communities, in the name of Jesus. We pull down the stronghold of the wicked today, Father, prevail in our midst. We bless you, God, in the name of Jesus. We thank you, Father, Lord, for anointing our tongues, Lord God, that we speak as your oracles in the name of Jesus. As we receive the word of truth, Father, Lord, we rightly distribute it without compromising in the name of Jesus. We commit ourselves to public reading of the scripture in the mighty name of Jesus, as Ezra and Nehemiah did in the name of Jesus. Father, Lord, because we know faith comes by hearing, and by hearing your word in the name of Jesus. Let your spirit do what your spirit can do in our midst, Lord God, as we read the scripture, as we meditate on your word, as we feed, Lord God, on spiritual truths in the name of Jesus. Father, instruct us. Oh, Rabba Hobo Shendaraba, rebuke and discipline us, for you discipline the children you love. We have come to you this day, not through our own righteousness, because we know we are falling short of your glory in so many ways. We ask for forgiveness. As you have forgiven us, Jehovah God, we forgive everyone that has sinned against us. Oh, Father, be thou exalted in our lives. Thank you, your grace gives us, Father Lord, the empowerment to forgive people of their sins in the name of Jesus. Be thou exalted, God, we bless you in Jesus' mighty name. Glory, hallelujah, amen. Father, we are blessing for our families, Lord God, that, Father Lord, our families, Lord, are built on solid foundation, Father Lord. We hold on to the truth, Lord God, we marry male to female, and we have passed the tradition on to our children. We rebuke the spirit of all deception in the world. We come against every contrary voice, Lord God. We come against anything confusing our children, Jehovah God, to accept their identities. We come against every lie. We pull down every stronghold of the enemy, Jehovah God. Triumph in our matters and the matters of our children, Jehovah God. We are in this world to give you pleasure in the name of Jesus. We are in this world to fulfill the ministry of entrusted to us in the name of Jesus. Oh Lord God Almighty, how can we populate, Father Lord, and reproduce and conquer this world? How can we replenish, oh Lord God, if we marry me to me or female to female? Satan, we rebuke you. The word of God is coming against you today. The blood of Jesus Christ is speaking against you and your devices. Oh Rabba Hobo Shendaraba, everything you have put in place to cause confusion is being overturned by the mighty power of God. The fire of the Holy Spirit descending upon your tent. The children of God are being delivered in the name of Jesus. Father, we bless you because the snare is being broken even right now. Your children, Father Lord, their eyes are being enlightened. Their minds are being renewed. You are pruning and removing from us everything contrary to your we. That, Father Lord, our ears will be attentive to your spirit in the name of Jesus. That we continue, oh Lord God, to contend for our most holy faith, oh Lord, to build on the foundations you have laid for us and our families. Jehovah God, we bless you. That the spirit of fruitfulness, oh Lord God, is amongst us in the name of Jesus. That we can reproduce and populate this earth in Jesus' mighty name. Oh Father, we bless you. We thank you that you have made our quivers to be full with children in the name of Jesus, that the enemy cannot find an entrance into our homes. We contend with the forces of darkness in the city gates in the name of Jesus. We pull them down, we trample upon them. Jehovah God, we shake the foundation of evil in our midst, Lord God, because you are giving us power to do so in the name of Jesus. Oh Father, we bless you. You are God. Be thou exalted in the name of Jesus. Glory, hallelujah, amen. Our Lord God Almighty, we bless you as we lift up our schools and higher institutions of learning to you. Brother, we bless you. Our children are writing their exams at this time. They are preparing for their final exams. Oh, Father, let the spirit of good success descend upon them. In the name of Jesus, separate from them everything evil, everything that will not make them to study, anything that will make them to be distracted. Oh, Father, we come against the spirit of fear. We come against the spirit of anxiety. We come against every attack in the brain. Father, we hope back your hands in the name of Jesus. We come against every spirit of lack of confidence in the mighty and precious name of Jesus. Father, touch our children from the crown of their heads to the sole of their feet in the name of Jesus. They can acquire skills and education to become responsible citizens of their nation. Oh Father, we bless you that our children, Father Lord, will rule the nations. Father Lord, they will be president of nations, so that they will rule both the public and the private sectors in the name of Jesus. We give you a clap offering for what you alone can do in the lives of our children. We bless you this day in the name of Jesus. Oh Father, shake the foundation of evil in our communities. Those that go into our schools, oh Lord God, with drugs. Remember with drugs, oh Lord God. We all rubber hobo shelter. Let your standard against them. Those that introduce Father Lord pornography. In rubber hobo shelter. Let your spirit come against them. Those that take Father Lord that use our children in sex trade and child labor. Let your standard against them. Let them be pulled down in the name of Jesus. Father, we are blessing you that children will return home. Those that have run away from their families, Jehovah God. We be sent rubber hobo shelter. You are shaking the foundations of Father Lord, of evil wherever they are in the name of Jesus. Oh, you are calling to their remembrance, their parents and siblings or their communities in the name of Jesus. Father, we bless you, God, in Jesus' mighty name. Glory, hallelujah, amen. Our Lord God Almighty, we are blessing for everyone working with our children, Jehovah God, that you are touching them in the name of Jesus. You are placing their rightful position within their schools, Lord God, to make decisions relating to our children, Jehovah God. Father Lord, you are enlightening their eyes, Lord God. You are giving their inner strength to press back against the forces of darkness in the schools. Father, you use your children mightily. Lift up their heads, Lord God. You are over every opposition. Jehovah God, bless them and their children in the name of Jesus. Do great works in them. Uproot from our schools, Lord God, everything contrary to your way. Disgrace the kingdom of darkness, Father Lord, or let them find no place to hide in the name of Jesus. Father, we bless you, God, in Jesus' mighty name. Our Lord God Almighty, we are lifting up to you today our children that are in jail and prison, incarcerated. Jehovah God, arise on their behalf this day. Touch them, Jehovah God, for we know they are great men and women in the prison. Oh Father Lord, we are praying that the prison ministry will go to preach, oh Lord God, the gospel of Jesus Christ to them. They will bring your children to repentance in the name of Jesus. Arise on behalf of your children struggling with drug addiction, Father Lord, and alcoholism. Oh Jehovah God, deliver them in the name of Jesus. We pray that their cases will be reviewed and they will be sent home in the mighty name of Jesus. For those, Father Lord, that committed crimes in their communities, you are God who gives more than a second chance to your children. Jehovah God, we pray that their cases will be reviewed. Oh Father Lord, that they will be sent home. Rabba Hobo Shenda. Oh Father Lord, in the name of Jesus, that those that have to spend their time, Father Lord, in prison and jail, Father Lord, that when they come and there will be better people in their communities, in the name of Jesus. Our Father, there are people who did not do anything wrong, that were wrongly accused, Lord God. Father, we are crying out to you on behalf of this ones. Jehovah God, arise to them in the name of Jesus, that their cases will be reviewed, that they will be sent back home. Give those, Father Lord, who send them to prison and jail, Father Lord, or everyone that participated in their cases, give them unrest, Father Lord. Let them find no peace, Jehovah God, until they are sent home in the name of Jesus. Father, we bless you, God, in the name of Jesus. We are lifting up the judiciary to you, Father Lord. Father Lord, you say that the wicked shall not be found in the congregation of the righteous, that they will not stand in judgment against us. Any unrighteous judge, Father Lord, any judge, Father Lord, that will not have love for your children, let their position become vacated by your mighty power in the name of Jesus. That those things will be filled with your children that have love for humanity in the name of Jesus. Father, we bless you, God, in Jesus' mighty name. We are lifting up to you this day law enforcement and the military, in the name of Jesus. We are thanking Jehovah God, Rabbah Habashan, for the various organs of the military, in the name of Jesus. We come against every activity of Satan, Father Lord, in the military. Anyone taking intelligent information to terrorists, anyone, Father Lord, supplying arms and ammunition and money to terrorists, we lift up a standard against them today. Let the blood of Jesus speak against them. Let them be disgraced and exposed in the name of Jesus. Father, let the military go out in your name, in the name of Jesus. Direct them, Father Lord. Let your light lead them, Father Lord, to those places where the terrorists are hiding in our communities. Jehovah God, arise unto your children. For this came against us at a time of peace, Father Lord. Oh, protect us, Father Lord, in the name of Jesus. Encompass around our nations, Lord God, as the mountain encompasses around Jerusalem. Protect your children where we go by air, by sea, oh Lord God, by land. Jehovah God, by the waterways, Father Lord. Be our God, in the name of Jesus. Guide and protect us in Jesus' mighty name. Oh, disgrace the kingdom of darkness on our behalf today. Father, lead us on that path you have laid for us and our families. In the name of Jesus, Father, we bless you, God, in Jesus' mighty name. Father, Lord, confuse the terrorists, Jehovah God. Let them use their own weapons against themselves. Let them be brought down by your own hands, Lord God. Jehovah God, Rabbah Habashan, arise unto the nations, Lord God. Deliver us in the name of Jesus. You are our Father. We are crying out to you in the name of Jesus. Have your way in our midst, Lord God. Oh, Rabbah Habashan, we plead the blood of Jesus. We ask for mercy in Jesus' mighty name. Glory, hallelujah, amen. Our Lord God Almighty, you are lifting up to you our sisters and brothers that are married, that are looking up to you for the blessing of the womb. Oh, children, an inheritance from you. The blessing of the womb is a reward. Touch your daughters, touch your sons, Jehovah God. Bless the wombs of your daughters to carry pregnancy to full term. Rebuke the enemy on their behalf, Jehovah God. Oh, we come against miscarriages. We come against the spirit of abortion. We come against any attack on the pregnancies and their mothers and their fathers. In the name of Jesus, Father, when it's time for the babies to be born, let your spirit overrun the maternities and help your children to bring forth their children into this world. In the name of Jesus, we bless you for the education of babies. Oh, Father, we thank you for what you alone can do in our midst. In the name of Jesus, our Lord God Almighty, we are crying out to you today concerning our children that are old enough to be married. Oh, Father, horrible Habashanda, we come against anything that will make our children to remain in their parents' home when they should be in their own homes. Satan, we rebuke you. We come against every altar erected in our families, Lord God, that we truncate the destiny of any child. We come against any word spoken against our children. We pull them down by the mighty power of God. Father, we restore back to our children everything that belongs to them. In the name of Jesus. Jesus. Oh, Rabbah Habashan, the will of God will be done in the lives of our children in the name of Jesus. Father, we have people are gathered in our families, Lord God. After our families against our children, Father Lord, overturn the captivity and confuse them. Disgrace them, Father Lord. We pull down, Father Lord, every covenant that has been taken against our children, Jehovah God. We may be sent that anything related to us and our family have been taken, Father Lord. So, Father Lord, against your will, this day, Father Lord, disgrace and pull down every temple contrary to your will in our families, Lord God. In the name of Jesus, Father Lord, we bless you for what your Lord can do for us. In the mighty name of Jesus, we return the curses back on the earth of senders. In the name of Jesus, Father Lord, you have not cursed us. No one can curse us and our children. In the name of Jesus, we bless you, God. Oh, Father, we thank you for what your Lord have done in our lives. In the name of Jesus, we prosper the work of our hands, Lord God. We thank you, Jehovah God, that we and our children prosper in good works. In the name of Jesus, that you establish us and our children. You teach us how to make with. In the name of Jesus, for your blessing makes rich and has no sorrow. You have given us these children, Father, your blessings to us. In the name of Jesus, they are good and perfect, Jehovah God. Remember, send them up a shinder. Fearfully and wonderfully created by you. Satan, we rebuke you. Our children are blessed by the names they are called. In the name of Jesus. Remember, send them up a shinder. We are blessed by the names we are called. In the name of Jesus. Oh, Father, we bless you for what your Lord can do in our midst. In Jesus' mighty name. Glory, hallelujah, amen. Father, Lord, at this time, we are blessing for our parents, our grandparents, Lord God. For the senior citizens in our midst, Lord God. We thank you for the great works you are doing in their lives, Lord God. That in old age, they are still strong for you. They are testifying about your faithfulness. You are still using them to do great works, Father Lord. Oh, Father, gladden their hearts this day. Anoint their heads with the oil of gladness. Jehovah God, to strengthen them from within. Father, use them to do great works. Rebuke the enemy on their behalf. Oh, Father, we pray that the children will remember them in old age. Father, use them in the name of Jesus to testify about your faithfulness, to support this generation. Oh, Father, we bless you that no one will abuse or neglect them. Jehovah God, wherever they go, let your spirit lead them in the name of Jesus. Oh, Father, those that are lonely, Jehovah God, we pray that they will find people that will come to them. Oh, in the name of Jesus, to take care of their needs, Lord God, in the mighty and precious name of Jesus. Father, thank you in Jesus' mighty name. Glory, hallelujah, amen. Father, we bless you this morning as we commit unto your hands various situations in our families, Lord God. You are God who makes situations beautiful in the lives of your children. Whatever we are passing through, Jehovah God, that you know, Jehovah God, as we have come to you this day, touch us. Help us, Father Lord, lift up our heads above the enemy's families, within our families and outside. Help us, Jehovah God, establish your way concerning us. Overturn every captivity in the name of Jesus. Those looking for jobs and better jobs, Father Lord, help them in the mighty name of Jesus. Let your light shine in their situations, Lord God. Let them find favor with me as they found with you. In the name of Jesus, those that are thinking where will the nearness may come from, send destiny helpers to them. In the name of Jesus, those that are seeking our families, Jehovah God, we commit them to your hands. You are God who heals our sicknesses and diseases. You want us to prosper. You want us to be in good as our souls prosper. In the name of Jesus, this day we rebuke the spirit of sickness and diseases. We come against every infirmity. Your spirit helps us in our weaknesses. Spirit of the living God, help us this day. Pray for us. O Rabba Kobo Shentanaba, from the crown of our heads to the sole of our feet, touch every part of our body. Rebuke the spirit of sicknesses. In the name of Jesus, rebuke cancer. Rebuke ulcer. Rebuke attack in our kidneys, livers, and lungs. Rabba Kobo Shentanaba, in our reproductive organs. Rebuke attack in our lower and small intestine. In the name of Jesus, in our large and small intestine. Rebuke attack in our lower back. In the name of Jesus, in our shoulders, in our hands, in our legs, Lord God. On our knees, Rabba Kobo Shentanaba, Kobo Shentanaba. In our heads, oh, can the hairs on our head. In the name of Jesus, that no man will pluck anything out of our body against the will of God. Flush from us our bodies today. Anything contrary to the will of God, in the name of Jesus. Bless the food we eat. Bless the water we drink. The air we breathe. In the name of Jesus. Bless everything. Yeah, food is planted in the name of Jesus. Oh, Rabba Kobo Shentanaba. Every medicine that we drink, oh, Rabba Kobo, we dip in the blood of Jesus. Everything used in the medical care of our children, the equipment, oh, Lord God, we dip in the blood of Jesus. The laboratory, the hospital, the nursing home, the rehabilitation centers, we flood every of the blood of Jesus, even within our families. Oh God Almighty, we bless you, God, for what you alone can do. In the name of Jesus, we commit unto your hands is the medical personnel taking care of your children. Oh, Rabba, the doctors in the various specialties. Oh, Father, hold your hands, oh Lord God. Anoint them afresh in the name of Jesus. Bless them, Father Lord. Let them know that they belong to the ministry of the great physician. Oh, Rabba, that they are under your leadership, that your spirit is leading them, Jehovah God. Oh, use them to do great miracles in the lives of your children every day. In the name of Jesus, give them confidence. We come against every fear. We come against distraction in the air. We rebuke the spirit in the air. We come against you. In the name of Jesus, you have no foundation where the children of God are. God, we prevail in our midst today. In the name of Jesus, we thank you for breakthrough in medical science, for what you alone can do. Oh, Father, be thou exalted. In the name and precious name of Jesus, oh, Father, we bless you, God. Separate along from your children everything evil in the medical profession. Those working for Satan, expose them. Oh, Father, frustrate their cancer. Or let them not agree on anything in the spiritual realm concerning your children. Let your hands come against them. Let the blood of Jesus speak against them. Let the fire of the Holy Spirit descend upon their tent, Lord God. Let them be scattered and brought down low. In the name of Jesus, Father, we bless you, God. In the name of Jesus, we thank you. We lift all the pharmaceutical companies to you today. We bless you for your children producing good medicine. Father, continue to use them to do great works. Those producing, Father, of fake medicine, we rebuke you. In the name of Jesus, the hand of God has come against you. Oh, Rabba Kobo Shentanaba, the blood of Jesus Christ is speaking against you. The fire of the Holy Spirit descending upon your tent. In the name of Jesus, you have been scattered. Oh, by the mighty power of God, you have been frustrated by the mighty power of God, for your evil has come upon your head. In the name of Jesus, Father, we bless you for the great works you alone can do. We thank you for the technicians in the laboratory. We bless you, God, for what you are doing through them. In the name of Jesus, for those working for you, they will continue to be prospered. In the name of Jesus, those working for Satan will frustrate you. The word of God is coming against you. You have been scattered. You have no foundation where the children of God are. In the name of Jesus, yes, Lord, prevail. In Jesus' mighty name, Jehovah God, we bless you this day. We thank you for what you alone can do. We come against death, Lord God, by stroke and sudden heart attack. We come against every attack on our arteries and veins. In the name of Jesus, on our nerves, oh, Rabba Kobo Shentanaba. In the name of Jesus, we come against any attack, Father Lord, in our blood pressure. In the name of Jesus, and blood sugar level. Flush out from our bodies everything contrary to your will. Stabilize everything concerning us this day. Father, be thou exalted. We lift up our hands and say, you are God. Remember, send the Kobo Shentanaba, there is victory where your children are. In the name of Jesus, you have sent what your word, Lord God. We receive it with thanksgiving today. In the name of Jesus, by the strength of Jesus Christ, we are already healed. Oh, Rabba Kobo Shentanaba, we bless you, God, in Jesus' name. Glory, hallelujah, amen. Lord God Almighty, we are blessing you. That your children in government will not be ashamed, Lord God, the gospel of Jesus Christ. That the heads of states and United Nations will know, Father Lord, that you hold each of them accountable for the things they are doing in the nations, Lord God. But I don't go back, Father Lord, to overturn, Father Lord, your ordinances that they are violated. That in one voice they will speak for you. In the name of Jesus, we come against every stubborn spirit. We are prudent, Jehovah God. They cannot take decision. They cannot make any decision concerning your children, Jehovah God. Separate them. In the name of Jesus, frustrate them. In the name of Jesus, arise to the nations today. The nations belong to you. You are God. For kings will come to you from faraway places, from our lands, Lord God. They will come to honor you. They will surrender to your will by your mighty power. In the name of Jesus, the heads of nations will come to you. They will seek wisdom. In the name of Jesus, they will know that you are God involved in the affairs of men. We lift up your children in the government to you, that they will lift up the banner of Jesus Christ. They will not be ashamed of the banner of Jesus Christ, because it's your power that give salvation to men. So those perishing, it is foolishness unto death. But we know, Father Lord, that every day you are revealing yourself to us. Every day you are helping us, Jehovah God. Every day you are knocking on the door of our hearts, Lord God. Where we will hear, Father Lord, that knock and open the door. You come in to dine with us. Oh, Father, be thou exalted. In the name of Jesus, we bless you, our living God. In Jesus' mighty name, glory. Hallelujah. Amen. The only God that presides in the great assembly. The gods fear you. We are not made God out of our hands, out of the things you created. We have come to you, the one and only true God. Today we are tearing and uprooting everything out of you. We are coming to you, Jehovah God. In the name of Jesus, we are blessing your children with nasty foreign religion, tearing down temples within their families. Oh, horrible ocean. Those turning from the worship of snakes, oh Lord God. Worship, oh Lord God, trees and mountains and rivers, oh Lord God. Those worshiping stars, oh Lord God. Worshiping the moon, in the mouth of the sun. They are turning back to you. In the name of Jesus. Oh, Father, we bless you for the great miracle you are doing in the nations, Father Lord. Your word, Father Lord, send faith, oh Lord God, in the sky, even as a faithful witness, let him more. In the name of Jesus, we bless you, God. Oh, for souls that are coming into the kingdom, we bless for the great commission that your children are going forth into the nation to preach the gospel of Jesus Christ. Thank you for those that have gone ahead of us. Strengthen them, Father Lord. Give them inner strength to stand against the forces of darkness in the nations. Overturn the captivity. Anyone trying to hinder the good works, bring them down, Jehovah God. In the name of Jesus, prevail where your children are with signs, wonders, and miraculous deeds, that the nations will know that you are truly God in the affairs of men. Oh, Father, we give you a clap offering. We thank you, God, that souls are coming, backsliders are coming into the kingdom in the name of Jesus. Thank you, Father, who spiritual gives you and bless us in the heavenly places in Christ Jesus, that we are standing in a rightful position in the body of Christ. Oh, blessed be your holy name in the name of Jesus. That your house is the house of prayer, not the den of robbers. In the name of Jesus, we come against the activity of false prophets and teachers in our midst. We frustrate them by your mighty power. We are tearing them down in the name of Jesus. But they have come to cause confusion, to scatter all, Lord God, to kill and to destroy. Where they have not given, they have not given within the body of Christ, Father, we've chased them out by your mighty power. In the name of Jesus, you have the light penetrate, Lord God, in our midst. Let it shine forth. In the name of Jesus, Father, we are committing unto your hands today. As spiritual fathers and mothers, hold all in position of spiritual leadership over us. In the name of Jesus, prune, purge, and touch them. Remove from you everything not of them, or not of you, in their lives, in the name of Jesus. Expose them, Father Lord, in the light of your word, that they will see themselves where they are, that they can repent of their sins in the name of Jesus. Oh, Father, we pray that they will return back to you in the mighty name of Jesus, that will continue to do great works for you in the mighty name of Jesus. Father, bless them and their families, Jehovah God. Oh, Rabba, Shindra, Bahaba, Sandra, Bahaba. Anyone trying to hand them, we come against them by the blood of Jesus. Oh, Father Lord, Horoba Hoboshida, anoint them, Father Lord, Horoba Hoboshida. Then they will continue to speak as your oracles in the mighty name of Jesus. Do you them to do great works that will support missions, God, in the name of Jesus, that will rise and distribute the word of truth to your children, Jehovah God, in the name of Jesus, that will not be men pleasers but God pleasers, in the mighty name of Jesus. Father, we thank you for that life. We thank you for the great works you do through them, in the name of Jesus. Be that exalted, our God, in Jesus' mighty name, Father. Thank you, Jehovah God, that we write and design the body of Christ, that we are different parts, but we belong to one body. We are united in one spirit in Christ, in the name of Jesus, that we come together in love. We come together in your name, in the name of Jesus, that you may have the first place in our midst, Lord God. We bless with divine blessing within the body of Christ. We thank you for the divine order. We thank you for the ministry of the Holy Spirit. We surrender to your spirit, Jesus, the spirit of the living God. Have your way in our midst. Rebbe Hema Shendara Bahawa. Release upon the church today the spirit of prayer. release upon the church today the spirit of discernment. In the name of Jesus, that we test every spirit. Not everyone has come in your name. Oh, blessed is he that has come in the name of the Lord. We pull down, Father Lord, every stronghold out of you. In the name of Jesus, for you have made us strong pillars within your house. We bless you, God. Be thou exalted. Our hands are lifted up to you this day. We say, Father, thank you. Oh, Rabba, Hobo, Shenda, Mama. Thank you that you are shaking down the foundation of evil. Thank you that you are exalted in our midst, Lord God. Thank you that you are God. Thank you, Jehovah God, Rabba, Hobo, Shenda, Mama, Hobo. That we are children of the day, Jehovah God. That is why it is day that we can work for you. Because night we come, we no matter can work. We are working for you. We are doing great works. We are being fruitful, Father Lord. In the name of Jesus. But it's by being fruitful that the world knows that we are your children. Father, be thy exalted. Oh, Rabba, Hobo, Shenda, Rabba, Hobo, Shenda, Rabba. Spirit of the living God, pray for us this day in the name of Jesus, that the will of God be done in our mercy on earth as it is in heaven. Father, have your way. We bless you, God, in Jesus' mighty and precious name we have prayed. Glory, hallelujah, amen. Blessed is he that comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. Father, Lord, we pray that wherever we go, that your word will be a lamp unto our feet and a light unto our path. In the name of Jesus. We are thank you, Jehovah God, for those that have been persecuted because of righteousness, even right now. Oh, Father, they will inherit your kingdom. They are blessed in the name of Jesus. Oh, Rabba, can we be sin that? Break every shame, Jehovah God. Overturn the captivity and deliver your children. That are captives to see your mighty power. Oh, Rabba, we shin that. Arise unto us, our Father. Let your enemies be scattered in the name of Jesus. From our afflictions, we are crying out to you. You are God, our helper. In the name of Jesus, we thank you, God, in Jesus' mighty name. Glory, hallelujah, amen. Father, we bless you for answered prayers. You have refreshed us this morning. You have led us beside still waters. You are still leading us beside still waters today. You are reviving our souls, O Lord God. Oh, Father, Rabba, Shenda, Rabba. You have set tables words in the presence of our enemies, Father Lord. We are feeding on those tables. Your rod and staff, Father Lord, are leading us through this world. We are not afraid of the deepest shadow of the valley of death. In the name of Jesus, Rabba, Rabba, Shenda. Because you are with us, Father Lord. Your goodness and mercy will continue to lead us wherever we go. Oh, Father, thank you. In the name of Jesus, we bless you, God. In Jesus' mighty and precious name we have prayed. Glory, hallelujah, amen. We pray that the word we feed on today will produce the fruit of righteousness in each one of us as we go into your word, Jehovah God. Enlighten our eyes. Let your word prune, purge, and remove from us everything not of you. For you discipline the children you love. We know you love us, Father Lord, and you have said nothing has separated us from your love. Glory, hallelujah. Blessed be God forevermore. In Jesus' mighty and precious name, we have prayed. Glory, hallelujah, amen. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah, amen. The Lord reigns. Blessed be our God. May the rock of our salvation be exalted. May our God be exalted in our midst today. Glory. Hallelujah. Amen. We have every reason to thank God. We have every reason to be thankful. God has done great things for us. Glory. Hallelujah. Amen. Psalm 150. Praise the Lord. Praise God in his sanctuary. Praise him in his mighty heavens. Praise him for his acts of power. Praise him for his surpassing greatness. Praise him with the sounding of the trumpet. Praise him with the harp and lyre. Praise him with tambourine and dancing. Praise him with the strings and flute. Amen. Praise him with a clash of cymbals. Praise him with resounding cymbals. Let everything that has breath praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Amen. Hallelujah. 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 First of all, to be praised. Hallelujah. Amen. In his sanctuary, praising in the firmaments of his powers, praising, praise the Lord, praising, praise the Lord, praising in his sanctuary, praising in the firmaments of his powers, praising the Lord, praising. In the sanctuary, praising in the firmaments of his powers. Glory, hallelujah, amen. This morning, I want us to read from 2 Corinthians chapter 5. Then we go back to make reference to the passage, the verses we've been meditating on, reflecting on from 2 Corinthians chapter 4. Verses 1 to 6. I will read it again, and the Spirit will do what the Spirit alone can do in us. The Word of God said that we should commit ourselves to public reading of the Scriptures. Amen. Ezra found out what was written about the people of Israel from reading the scripture. Nehemiah also found out, we will find out God's purpose for our lives. We know our relationship with God, who we are to God, and who God is to us. Whom God is to us. When we study the Word of God, when we read the Spirit of God, we do great works in us. That Word that goes inside of us will produce the fruit of righteousness when we commit ourselves to reading the Scripture. God will do what God alone will do. He has given us each a measure of faith. We have the Spirit to help us, to help our understanding. We believe that God will do great works in us in the name of Jesus. Even if we cannot explain it, let's read it. There's a time that the Spirit will quicken us. And the verses we have read, we just come. Read and read. Let the Spirit do what the Spirit will do. Faith comes by hearing, and it's by hearing the Word of God. When we read the Word of God, we are hearing the voice of God. The Word of God, God backs His Word with His power and His authority. And God has given us that Word. He has given us His power and His authority. But we cannot do anything from God if we do not know what God says concerning our situation or who we are or what God expects us to do. We will not even know the kind of life that we are living now. When we say that we have the life of Jesus Christ, we have to read so that we know exactly what God expects of us. Amen. Faith comes by hearing, and it's by hearing the Word of God. We must read. Public reading, not for ourselves alone, but for everybody. There's a promise in the book of Revelation that when you read it, you are blessed. And when you read it to the hearing of other people, they are blessed. Amen. Let's read it. Read the Word of God. Double blessings in Jesus' mighty name. Glory. Hallelujah. Amen. 2 Corinthians chapter 5, our heavenly dwelling. That's all of us in this world. We are living here with great expectations to inherit God's eternal kingdom. Amen. That when we die, we will be with God. Jesus Christ said, in my Father's house are many mansions, that I've gone ahead of you to prepare a place. That we are, and there you will be. That I have to go to prepare a place for you. And God will send you the promise of the Spirit. Amen. So we are in this world. We are all living. Amen. Knowing that this world is not our final dwelling place. That we have it. A heavenly dwelling place. That we will be with God. So even the fact that we are in this world and we're going about our businesses, we are all groaning in our spirit. Our spirit are crying within us. Amen. Whether we believe it or not. Because we know that this is only finite place, dwelling place for us. That all of creation is earnestly waiting for the revelation of God's children. That creation cries, groans as if in the pain of childbirth. Going through that same pain of childbirth. Because all of creation is waiting for the revelation of God's children. That God himself submitted creation to go through that pain. Amen. So as long as we are in this world in flesh and blood, we have great expectations of where we will spend the rest of eternity. We are constantly thinking about it. We are constantly searching for God. Constantly searching for better things because we know that we have not attained unto perfection in the name of Jesus. That we are just in this world. That we are in a life's journey. And when we allow the Spirit of God to lead us, we get to our destinations in the name of Jesus. So there's a groaning inside of us. Deep spiritual groaning inside of us for the things of God. Amen. Even those that have turned their backs against God, there is a groaning inside of them for the things they are seeking in that kingdom of darkness, because the God of this world has blinded their eyes. They cannot see any spiritual things. They are in the wrong places. Some have erected temples and things looking for God in the things that God created because they are searching for God in the wrong places. We remember when Paul went to Athens, he saw the people. He said, you are very religious people. As I walk around your cities, I can see various temples. But I've come to reveal to you the one and only true God. Amen. So men may have erected temples in that search for God. They may have created God out of their own hands. But we pray that we that have been enlightened, that our eyes have been opened by the Spirit of the living God, not through our own power, not through our own might, but God himself. Because we humble ourselves before God, that as we come across people searching for God in the wrong places, that is, we should take the opportunity to reveal one another the true God to them. Amen. So that men we come to know God. We are here on a ministry of reconciliation, whether we like it or not. Reconciling this entire world, appealing with the Spirit of God, employing men to turn back from the crooked path to come to God. Shouting and crying out to men with wisdom that God has given us salvation in Jesus Christ, that there's no other way through which men may be reconciled back to God, unless through Jesus Christ. There's no other way. There's no other way. Jesus Christ is the truth, is the light, is the way that leads them to God. Glory. Hallelujah. Amen. So let us know that why we are here, our mission on earth, and be busy about doing it in Jesus' mighty name. Amen. Now we commit ourselves to reading. I've just explained in a nutshell what this passage that we're going to read is about. Glory. Hallelujah. Amen. May the Spirit now minister to us in Jesus' mighty name. Glory. Hallelujah. Amen. Our heavenly dwelling. Now we know that if the earthly tents we live in is destroyed, we have a building from God, an eternal house in heaven, not built by human hands. Meanwhile, we groan, longing to be clothed with our heavenly dwelling. Because when we are clothed, we will not be found naked. For while we are in these tents, we groan and are burdened, because we do not wish to be unclothed, but to be clothed with our heavenly dwelling, so that what is mortal may be swallowed up by life. Now it is God who has made us for this very purpose, and has given us the Spirit as a deposit, guaranteeing what is to come. Glory. Therefore, we are always confident and know that as long as we are at home in the body, we are away from the Lord. We live by faith, not by sight. We live by faith, not by sight. We are confident, I say, and would prefer to be away from the body. And at home with the Lord. That's what we prefer, to be at home with the Lord. But we are in this world. And as long as we are here, we are searching for the righteous God. We have great expectations to inherit God's kingdom. And that will never fail us. In the name of Jesus, our spirit continues to grow inside of us, looking forward to God's promises for us in the name of Jesus. So we live by faith, because we can only claim the promises of God through faith, not by works, not by human will. And that's why God gave each of us a measure of faith each. And God has given us his Spirit to help us in our journey here on earth, that we do not do anything by our own power, but by the Spirit of God, working in us and through us to perfect the will of God. God also gave us his grace. God has placed everything in this world to help us. His grace that trains us, that gives us the power to say no to ungodly living. Amen. Our eyes will be enlightened when we come to God. God will help us. Wisdom is crying out. Crying out. Because God does not delight in the death of a sinner. He does not want anyone to die and leave this world without knowing where they will spend their eternal life. He has given everyone a free way to make that choice, where you want to spend your eternal life. But if that choice is outside of God's plan, then we know that to be in hell with Satan. Amen. Men make up their mind. God is not going to force himself on anyone. He has given us everything. He wants us to trust him. He wants us to come to him. He's not slack about his promises. He's given us time to take this message to the outermost ends of the world. There are souls that have been assigned to every human being there. We have a ministry in each family. Bring everybody within your family to God. And from there, start branching out into your communities to do the work God has called you to do. In the name of Jesus. This is serious. Amen. We do not live forever. in the name of Jesus. Glory, hallelujah, amen. Therefore, we are always confident and know that as long as we are at home in the body, we are away from the blood. We live by faith, not by sight. We are confident, I say, and we prefer to be away from the body and at home with the Lord. So we make it our goal to please Him. We make it our goal to please God while we are here. Glory. Whether we are at home in the body or away from it. For we must all appear before the judgment seat of Christ. Amen. We must all appear before the judgment seat of Christ. I heard someone writing something. I read some write up on someone's Facebook page. The person was saying that everything about Christ's second coming, the second coming of Christ, is all forgotten, all redundant, has no meaning for this present generation because Christ will not come again. I read it, I said, who is teaching this lady? Who is instructing this lady and telling her this lie that is against the kingdom of God? Christ will come again. And a lot of people are holding on to that truth, that Christ will not come again, that there's no judgment. But from the word of God, Christ is going to come again. There's going to be judgment in the name of Jesus. So let us be mindful of the things we do. Amen. Because we have not attained unto spiritual maturity. We are training ourselves and preparing ourselves to get to that standard of spiritual maturity where God wants us to be. Amen. There's work for us to do in the kingdom. Every day, no one is perfect. Amen. No one of us. We need God. We must plead the blood of Jesus and ask for mercy in the name of Jesus. As long as we are in flesh and blood. In Jesus' mighty name. Amen. Amen. We must all appear before the judgment seat of Christ, that each one may receive what is done, what is due him for the things done while in the body, whether good or bad. There's a reward, whether it's good or bad. The ministry of reconciliation. That's why I want us to pay attention to the ministry of reconciliation. Since then, we know what it is to fear the Lord. We try to persuade men. Since we know what it is to fear the Lord, we try to persuade men. What we are is plain to God. And I hope it is also plain to your conscience. We are not trying to commend ourselves to you again, but are giving you an opportunity to take pride in us so that you can answer those who take pride in what is seen rather than in what is in the heart. If we are out of our mind, it is for the sake of Christ. If we are in our mind, in our right mind, it is for you. For Christ's love compels us. Because we are convinced that one died for all, and therefore all died. We live for Christ. Christ's love compels us to think about the salvation of souls. Amen. That we do not live for ourselves alone, in the name of Jesus. And He died for all, that those who live should not live for themselves, but for Him who died for them and was raised again for Christ. We do not live for ourselves, but for Christ. Amen. So from now on, we regard no one from a worldly point of view. Amen. Though we once regarded Christ in this way, we do so no longer from a heavenly point of view. The wisdom that comes from above. Amen. Knowing that Christ died for us, that the life we live now is the life of Christ. That we are here to work for Christ to bring souls into the kingdom. Amen. We do not even regard Christ from a worldly point of view because we know He's the child of God, the only Son of God that came into this world to bring us salvation, to reconcile us to God, that we have salvation in Him, in Jesus' name. Glory, hallelujah, amen. Therefore, if any man is in Christ, he is a new creation. He is a new creation. Amen. The old has gone. The new has come. We are new people in Christ. Amen. All this is from God, who reconciled us to Himself through Christ and gave us the ministry of reconciliation. God did it. He reconciled all of us. Made us new creation in Christ. Amen. Reconciled us in Christ. Christ will die for us and we may have new life. All started from God. Amen. Through Jesus Christ, we are reconciled back to God. And we are now in that ministry of reconciling the entire world, appealing with the, working with the Spirit of God, appealing to men to be reconciled to God in the name of Jesus. Amen. Therefore, if any man is in Christ, he is a new creation. The old has gone, the new has come. All this is from God, who reconciled us to himself through Christ and gave us the ministry of reconciliation. That God was reconciling the world to himself in Christ, not counting men's sins against them. Forgive us of all our sins in Jesus Christ. God not counting our sins against us. He did it for his love for us. Glory, hallelujah, amen. That he sent Jesus Christ to die for us, that the whole world may be reconciled back to him. Not counting the sins of men against them. Glory, hallelujah, amen. Amen. And he has committed to us the message of reconciliation. What do we have? That ministry that we refer to in 1 Corinthians chapter 4. That ministry is the ministry of reconciliation. That's what we have. That's why we are busy here. And that's why we have renounced every shameful way. Everything that will bring reproach, every deceit, amen. Because we must hold on to the truth and reveal the truth to the world. We cannot have any secrets when we have a ministry of reconciling God's children back to him. God who has forgiven us of all our sins. No secret, no deceit. We commend the truth to the consciousness of men, the way we have received it, and let the Spirit of God walk in men to bring them to God in the name of Jesus. Glory. Hallelujah. Amen. We bless God in the name of Jesus. Christ not counting men's sins against them, and he has committed to us the message of reconciliation. We are therefore Christ's ambassadors. We are then therefore Christ's ambassadors. As though God, we are making his appeal through us. So who are we? Christ's ambassadors, as though God was making his appeal through us. We implore you on Christ's behalf, be reconciled to God. That's what we do. We appeal to the world on Christ's behalf, that the world be reconciled to God. God made him who had no sin to be sin for us, so that in him we might become the righteousness of God. That God made him who was no sin for sin for us, so that through him we may be reconciled back to God in Jesus' mighty name. Amen. I said I was going to read some verses from 2 Corinthians chapter 4 also. Therefore, since 4 verse 1 to 6, I'll just read it. Amen. And let the Spirit minister to us. Therefore, since through God's mercy we have this ministry of reconciliation, amen, appealing to men to come back to God through Christ, amen, mercy, we have this ministry. We do not lose heart. Rather, we have renounced secret and shameful ways. We must renounce secret and shameful ways. There must be no lie in us, no darkness in us, because we are children of the light. Let us be filled with the truth that we have received from God. That's the only way we can bring souls into the kingdom. If there's darkness in us, the world will see that darkness, because spiritual things speak of their own accord. Amen. Spiritual things have voice. Unspoken voice that people can see. If the glory of God is in us, people will see it. If there's evil in us, we cannot hide. People will see that there's something wrong here. Spiritual things speak of their own accord by the mighty power of God in the name of Jesus. Amen. So we must, whether we like it or not, if we are truly Christ's ambassadors in this world, if we are truly in the ministry of reconciliation, bringing souls to God, we must. I'm saying using the word must, because there's no other standard through which we may walk with God or have any fellowship with him. We do not belong to God if we refuse to renounce secret things. Amen. sinful and shameful ways. We must renounce them by the power of God. We must. We have renounced secret and shameful ways. We do not use deception, nor do we distort the word of God. On the contrary, by setting forth the truth plainly, we commend ourselves to every man's conscience. Commend ourselves to every man's conscience in the sight of God. And even if our gospel is veiled, it is veiled to those who are perishing. Tell the truth. Even if people do not understand, they refuse, we know they are perishing. For those that God has predestinated for salvation, they will receive it, they will welcome it, and you produce life in them. In the name of Jesus. Glory. Hallelujah. Amen. And even if our gospel is vain, it is vain to those who are perishing. The God of this age has blinded the minds of unbelievers so that they cannot see the light of the gospel of the glory of Christ. Because the God of this age has blinded their eyes, but God has given us spiritual enlightenment, and our eyes are enlightened to see clearly. Like Father Abraham saw. He had faith to see beyond the circumstances, to see far as his eyes could go. God said, I've given you everything. And I believe God in the name of Jesus. Glory, hallelujah, amen. The God of this age has blinded the eyes of unbelievers so that they cannot see the light of the gospel, of the glory of Christ, who is the image of God. That's why they cannot accept him. For we do not preach ourselves for Jesus Christ as Lord, and ourselves as your servant for Jesus' sake. For God who said, let light shine out of darkness, may this light shine in our hearts to give us the light of the knowledge of the glory of God in the face of Christ. Blessed be Jesus Christ. Blessed be God. Blessed be the Spirit of the living God. Blessed be God. Hallelujah. Father, we just bless you for your faithfulness. We thank you that we are fed on your word today. We bless you for total victory, O Lord God, in our ministries here on earth. We bless you, Jehovah God, that we can reconcile men to you, that we are your ambassadors. We bless you, God, that you have enlightened our eyes, O Lord God, that we are not blinded by the gods of this world. We thank you, Jehovah God, for the souls that we bring into the kingdom, for the power in your word. We bless you, Jehovah God. We exalt your holy name. Thank you, God, that the life we are living is the life of Jesus Christ. That we saw your image in him, Jehovah God, and we are able to accept him. And because you have called us to this great ministry of reconciliation, Jehovah God, we have renounced secret and shameful ways. In the name of Jesus. Thank you, not by our power, but by your spirit. That spirit working in us even right now in the name of Jesus and through us to profit your way. Father, be thou exalted in our midst. We bless you in Jesus' mighty name. Thank you for everything you have done for us and our families. Be thou exalted, O Lord God. In Jesus' mighty name we have prayed. Glory. Hallelujah. Amen. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Amen. The Lord reigns. Blessed be our God, be the rock of our salvation, be exalted, may God be exalted in our lives today. Glory, hallelujah, amen. Be blessed. God loves you. We love you too. Glory, hallelujah, amen.